A lot has been happening over the last couple of years with the surveying community in the United States. It's been very powerful, and it's been something good to watch. But we're also at a critical time, and it really comes down to education. And you know, one of the things that we have noticed is that going around the country, there are a tremendous number of companies, geospatial companies, whether it's the conventional surveying companies or the new mapping companies, that are literally crying for people with a good background in geospatial capacity. And we're suffering from that. There are educational opportunities here. There are universities, but not many have a full four-year degree in either surveying, geodesy, it's almost gone, or geomatics. And you know, we're just wondering, could you give us some perspectives on what you see in the most successful areas of the world? You know, who is having the greatest success in doing this, and how might we benefit from what they've done? Please.
Well, it's an honor for me to be here, but honestly, I didn't expect that this would be the situation, because in my university we have good education for surveyors, but most of them they want to come here and to continue and to found a job and all that. So yes, indeed, there are so many fields that are coming appearing now. So it's the big data and the management of big data and all that. It's all this technology with mobile services that it is very important for surveyors also to get to know how to use this technology and how to improve their capacity in order to deliver in time and in a very low cost there. Products and how they are going to use it. It's the UAVs. That's a great opportunity for surveyors to produce any kind of reliable data. And
sure.
Here in the United States, we have so much technology on that. And I would believe that everyone from all around the world will come here and see all the updated and new developments in real-time management of spatial data and in navigation and capturing and data UAV and all that, and MIT is doing so good work.
It's an exciting time, to be
yeah.
sure. I know you were in town to be a part of the World Bank conference on land and poverty. Could you give us just a couple of minutes on what occurred there and the role for surveyors as part of that global effort?
Yes, we are doing this. This is a joint global effort, and actually we are trying to coordinate a little bit more with the World Bank and FIG for the Sustainable Development Goals and trying to eliminate poverty, at least extreme poverty, within one generation, which is really very important. It's a very challenging thing for the whole world and all governments. Well, the whole story is to make it successful. So we have done so much work in FIG developing a fit-for-purpose approach in all our activities, services, and products. But of course, this does not mean lower accuracy or whatever. It means delivering reliable information affordably and in time. And this is a great opportunity for all of you to contribute. Of course, this fit-for-purpose approach needs to be improved further, because once we capture the data, then this is the big challenge. We need to make
yeah.
it sustainable. And in order to make it sustainable, my opinion is that we need to develop the profession in all the regions. There are regions that they don't have land surveyors,
yeah.
and we can never say that we don't need land surveyors, because technology has improved.
Yes.
Of course, we do need land surveyors. We do need all the new trends in surveying. we need appraisers. Most of the surveyors are active in valuation aspects. Dispute resolution, land management, land readjustment, urbanization, everything. We need fit for purpose planning also, and I think there is a great opportunity for you in your region to contribute to the international society in this field. And we need to develop all the necessary professionals that are involved in the property markets, because actually the final purpose is not that just to privatize the land,
right,
and to develop land administration systems,
yes,
but it is to make the property market
work
all over the place. So you have a great experience in that,
yeah,
in property markets. So I don't expect from you to say that you need input from other regions, because you are leading.
One of the things I know that before I left the National Geodetic Survey, we were working on a plan for new reference frames for the country come 2022. And one of the guiding reasons for this, one of the foundational efforts that we see ongoing, is the incredible developments that we're going to see in the next couple of years in space-based positioning. Hopefully the United States will start launching the GPS-3 next year, which will be a whole new modernization of the architecture of the network. Galileo is coming along very strong, and everybody's very pleased to see that. GLONASS will get there, and we know the Chinese are going to be very active in this area. So one of the things that I know many of us at NGS had looked at is the potential for perhaps 10 centimeter positioning with no surface monuments, just from the satellites, in a few years, in a cell phone. And I know when I speak to the surveyors in the United States, and I say, well, imagine 300 million people just in the United States able to achieve, let's say, 10 centimeters real time, no ground control, and able to share that instantaneously with everybody else. Assuming that becomes the case, and I think many of us believe it will, it's just a matter of the timing, how might you see that as a positive role in the aspects that surveyors and others are going to deal with globally, when now we might have potentially 7 billion people with access to this technology, cheap in a cell phone? How do you see a way in which that can vastly contribute to the work that surveyors are doing, or do you see it as something that would be in conflict?
No, I don't see that it will be in conflict. Many surveyors believe that this may affect their income.
Yeah.
But well, it is an issue in our days. Technology goes very fast, and the challenge is that for all of us, all kinds of professions, not just surveyors. They all use technology, so they all need to be updated.
Yeah.
They all need to have continuous capacity development, mm-hmm, and they all need to see the chances where they can use the new technology and where they can be useful for the society. So the
sure
challenge for the surveyors is to see where is the need and what they can contribute within,
mm-hmm,
one generation, with the next generation, and the generation after, because
yeah,
problems are not going to be solved so quickly because technology is so fast.
Sure.
But technology helps a lot, helps a lot, and we need to, 4 year or 5 year, even 5 year, we have in my place, we have 5 year education, academic education for surveyors. It's not enough for the rest of your life.
Yeah.
Every year technology is improving, so you have to be updated. You have to have imagination, and you have also you must have the ability to look ahead and see what the society would expect from you and what the coming generation would expect from the surveyors, and all this geospatial data management for sustainable cities, for smart cities. The urbanization issue is going to be very big, very huge, all kind of things. need to be all our tools or our methodologies in the surveying, not just simple surveying, but also the management of the land, the management of the data, the property markets, yeah, everything. So it's a broad field that surveying is covering at the moment. It's
yeah,
not only measurements,
right,
which is of course very important, navigation and everything else, but all the rest, the management of the land, of the sea, of the built
yeah
environment, that surveyors can be very active. But they have to keep on, they have to be close to the associations, the national associations, the international associations. Also, FIG has to be very close to the corporate members and to the technology. And we need to develop training courses. We need to develop a global agenda altogether.
Yeah. I think a global agenda is certainly one, personally, I think it's one, you know, that could benefit all of us. And I'm certainly glad to hear some of the focus that you pointed out about the rising needs that are coming, of course, globally. And that's why I think the value of the Young Surveyors Program is so important, and FIG taking a leadership role in that a few years ago has been marvelous, and we're certainly hoping that will grow here in the United States. So far we're making strides, and it's working, it's evolving, but I know when I talk to the young surveyors in the States that just attended the recent meeting back in February, I guess it was, young surveyors just from my own state of Maryland, coming back, it was almost like kids at Christmas, you know, eyes wide open, because while these are people who certainly travel, they take their families on vacation, etc., they rarely travel professionally. They work in their backyard, they live in this environment, and their world is only the world of a couple of counties in Maryland or anywhere else in the United States. And to listen to the stories that they were telling, coming back, meeting with other surveyors, young surveyors from Canada and from Washington State and Colorado, it was just an exciting time. And so I'm sure, but I'm hoping FIG is going to push that even further, because obviously the young surveyors are the ones who are going to guide this future.
Yeah,
and
there's a whole world that is opening for the young surveyors. There's no need for them only to restrict their professional activity in a neighborhood.
Yeah.
They can be there, they can be by the beach, and they can do their job all over the world. And this is marvelous.
Yeah.
You can cooperate with other surveyors all over the world. You
yes
can cooperate also with other professionals with all over the world, and you can have your activity, and technology is so improved that this is also very good from my experience for the young surveyors in my country, that we are now in the economic crisis, and they can even find jobs to do outside the country, even
mm-hmm
without the need to move out of the country.
Yeah.
So technology is so marvelous.
Yeah, it is. Yeah. Could you give us a sense of some of the some of the burning issues that you see as president of FIG? What are the kinds of things you'd like to see accomplished during your term?
Mm. Mm.
A big agenda.
It's a big agenda.
Yes.
Well, what we try to do is, first of all, we try to establish a very good, to continue the very good cooperation that we have with all international organizations.
Yeah.
And this is the major focus with the World Bank and the United Nations, the geospatial information community all over the world, for the global agenda, global sustainable development agenda. So we try to contribute as much as possible, to bring knowledge back to FIG, to the member associations, and the member associations need to bring back knowledge to their surveyors. And the effort is to develop the global surveyor, a surveyor that can address all the global issues and understand what is the whole issue with the global development agenda. Of course, we are also trying to to improve the internal structure of FIG as well.
Mm-hmm.
It's a long time since we did a review of
mm-hmm.
of our structure, and I thought that it is the right timing to do that. And I'm not saying that necessarily we need to restructure, but just to review
mm-hmm.
and to see if there is any need or that. So. We are working on this issue also, and how we will improve our communication with our member associations, and how we will manage to distribute all our products to the grassroots surveyors and all that. Also, how we will develop a better relationship with our corporate members in the industry.
Oh, yes.
This is, I think this is very important. And. Especially because I want to see that all these new technology and all these improvements are very directly communicated within FIG. And this is one of my major concerns. And of course, this is connected with our publications
mm-hmm.
and the journals that we want to cooperate.
Mm-hmm.
And also just being active in my greater region, in the countries in transition and the emerging property markets, I have a focus on how surveyors can contribute better and understand what exactly is the purpose. Because we say fit for purpose approaches, but I'm sure that the purpose is not very clear among all governments and among all politicians
mm.
and among all professionals. So I'm trying to do something in this field, and I'm trying to draw the attention of surveyors in this field in developing property markets and see the needs and how we can communicate with other professionals that
okay.
are involved.
Okay. I could certainly appreciate
also to cooperate with our other professional associations, sister
mm-hmm.
associations, ISPRS and
right.
all the rest.
Right.
We need to be very close.
I can certainly appreciate the issue of dealing with politicians. That's, I think that's a global issue. And yeah, it's unfortunate, but it's a global issue. And I'm sure you don't know how to crack that nut. None of us does. But there's a we need a stronger global effort on this, you know, to share this. It's a great challenge.
It is a great challenge, yes. And technology helps.
Yeah.
It helps us a lot because we can collect the data and we can have more reliable data.
Yeah.
And maybe less manipulated data.
That's what we'd like to see.
Okay.
Great. Thank you.